Hello, you beautiful space travelers. It is Space Bird here, and today I have the Warhammer Age of Sigmar Champions Founders box. There was only about 1,000 of these, and luckily I had about 5 minutes left and I was able to snag one. I figured with all that came with it, it was well worth a buy. I played Force of Will. I currently play UFS. I never got really into Magic, so I'm kind of looking for another card game to learn and get into. But because I'm new, I wanted something relatively easy to learn. There was like 4 or 5 videos on this that I watched in like 20 minutes and completely learned how to play. So I've already opened this box, but I put it back together and hopes to kind of show you guys. So right on the top, they give you this really cool poster board with a lot of the characters that I've seen on there. So at the top here, they give us the playing mats. These kind of help you how to play because it has a lot of the setup on how you move the cards. Before we get into the cards, we'll see kind of like how the mats look like. These are basically how your life goes. You start at a base of 30 and your characters kind of help you either move up or move down. I'll show those kind of where they are on the card later. You basically have 4 champions, 4 blessings, and 4 actions. You get about 2 actions a turn. They do give you 2 mats. I'm going to go ahead and leave this one in the case. I believe they do look exactly the same. I could be wrong. You know, I could just completely mess it up. This is, I believe, just kind of the lore on a lot of it. Next video, we'll just sit and read that out loud. I'm sure that'll work out. Oh, that's really nice. I didn't see this before. They give you like a little written note. Let's see if I can actually focus. Now these, I believe, are the tokens. I probably like this one the best. Or maybe this one. Now this one's just a deck box, but I love the shape of it. And it has some really, really cool art. So the cards in general, just kind of their style and how they feel, how thick they are, is really, really nice. The only drawback that I have seen since I opened this last night and opening it now is the cards do have a little bit of bend once you kind of take them out. The foiling is really cool. It kind of reminds me of Force of Will more than like UFS. This one is one of the champions. The green is how much it costs. You can only have 20 to kind of fill up your champion. Some cost 2, some cost 10, some cost 15, I believe. This is what kind of gives you the life plus or life minus. So this is 2, so you'll start at 30, then you'll go to 32, depending on kind of what the rest of your warriors say. This foiling still reminds me of Force of Will. Now, not all of them bend so bad. If you see this one compared to the other one, really didn't bend that much. Now, if I decide to not play Chaos, the next one I want to play is probably the Aurochs. I'm sure you've seen some of these, you know, the green number down here. This one is quite a lot. It's 15. Remember, you can only have 20, so you can only have 5 more points to spend, but he is really, really powerful. So we have the Chaos Champion. I really, really like the Chaos art, which is why I'm fighting between playing Chaos and the Oryx. They kind of have like a death-esque and a blood-esque, which is usually kind of what I like to play in games. The Aspiring Deathbringer. Alright, now that we've gotten kind of some of the bigger stuff done, I'm going to scoot these back, we'll zoom in, and we'll actually sit down. This one is the Insatiable Blood Reaver. It says that as this enters play, remove a highlighted unit, damage to your opponent, and gain 2 health. So on its first play, it doesn't do anything, but on its next rotation, it does 3 damage. And they give us another one. And they give us another one called Twisting Screamer. It says reduce damage received from highlighted enemies by, you know, whatever its rotation is. Alright, this one is the Tactical Formation. It says draw 1 card, swap this champion's position with a highlighted disengaged champion. Now we're on into the abilities. Now you'll see this one says Ability Wizard. Sometimes they say any, but that means that this one can only be played by wizards. Right here is the Furious Strike. Now this one says Ability Warrior, so it can only be played by warriors, not wizards. This one says 1 damage to your opponent increases by 1 for each highlighted disengaged champion. That is your own champions. It's called Blood Hunt, and that definitely, yeah, looks like Blood Hunt. Now this one says remove a highlighted spell or unit and gain 1 health. This one is called Scorn of Sorcery. Can only be played by warriors. 2 damage to your opponent increases by 3 if the highlighted champion controls a spell. Now you'll notice with these do not quite have, you know, the round corners like that. So these just kind of come in, they do their thing, and then they leave. This one is Opportunity Strike. 2 damage to your opponent increases by 3 if there are no highlighted units in play. Now this is a spell. Reduce damage received from highlighted enemies and allies by first 2 and then 1. This is another spell. Rejoice in Slaughter, of course. Why not? When a highlighted ally removes a unit, draw that many cards. Now, in learning the game, as I'm sure you probably know more than I do, I'm just started learning, it does start with the top left. And so, you know, you turn it, there's your top left, and then, you know, he would die as he has no more to do. Here we have another spell, Infernal Gateway. It makes me think of Eternal Gateway. This one says when a highlighted ally deals 1 or more damage to either player, gain that much health. So at first 2, then 1. Let's say another one. This is Arcane Bolt. This one I like quite a bit, just because, you know, its first 2 times it doesn't do much, which is eh, but on its last go around it does do 7 just damage to the face. And they give you another one. So that is the champion deck. This one was super helpful in my first game just because, you know, a lot of the words I kind of got basically how they meant, but it kind of goes into a better detail. And if you are watching this and you also play the game online, all of these booster ones are completely scannable. First champion that we get is the Skeleton Champion. It says heroic act, discard 1 from your hand to gain 2 health. The next one is the Bloody Vampire Queen. Now she says, when this champion removes a highlighted unit, remove 1 vampire unit from your discard pile to your hand. Which is not bad. Get you some extra cards in hand. It says, ignore any damage from a highlighted enemy or ally
that would defeat you instead gain 4 health and expire this blessing.
Turmoil of Souls.
4 damage to your opponent. Shuffle 2 cards from your opponent's hand into their deck. This is Carry On Feast. It does have another heroic act. Damage to your opponent, gain that many health. Rotate this 1 step forward. And we've got Supernatural Horror. Now the offer him is pretty wicked. He is the Ravenous Crypt Ghoul. You do that much damage to your opponent, so the first time, not much, but the rest time around it goes up by 1. Give us another one. Now this one is the Freakish Cryptor. His face is quite great. This is damage to your opponent and gain that much health. Give us another one. Twice the horror. Corners 1 and 2, gain that much health. Corners 3, draw that many cards. This one just says that much damage to your opponent. 2 murders. This one is the Crypt Shield Black Knight. Corners 1 and 2, reduce damage received from highlighted enemies by that much. Corners 3, damage to your opponent. We've got 2 horses. We've got a Frenzy one. This one says, damage to your opponent, remove a highlighted unit. If a unit was removed, gain 1 additional action this turn. This one is the Charging Black Knight. Remove a highlighted unit and that much damage to your opponent. This one is the Zombie Dragon. The art on this one is also... the art on all of these is really amazing, but some of them, they really, really stand out. So the Zombie Dragon, as this enters play, discard 1 card from your hand and rend damage to your opponent. Now we're on to our spells. This one says reduce damage received from highlighted enemies and allies by that much. It's another spell, a terrifying one. This can only be deployed by a vampire, champion, highlighted units, and spells are dormant. Got the Frightful Touch. This one says damage to your opponent. If the highlighted champion does not control a unit, your opponent must shuffle 2 cards from the hand into their deck. That's pretty rough. Got another Arcane Bolt. That much damage to your opponent. Give us another one. This one says rend damage to your opponent, gain that much health. I'll give you some more souls to steal. This one says remove a highlighted spell or unit, shuffle 1 unit from your discard pile into your deck. Call of the Grave, personally I might not answer, but this one says gain 1 health, shuffle up to 2 units from your discard pile into your deck. Tactical Formation. Draw 1 card, swap this champion's position with a highlighted disengaged champion. Bloodthirst, this can only be played by vampires. If the champion has removed a highlighted unit this turn, gain 6 health. Here we got Brutal Smash. 2 damage to your opponent, increases by 4 if their hand size is 8 or more. Here we've got Cursed Strike. This one says 3 damage to your opponent. You may rotate a highlighted spell or unit 1 step backwards or forwards. Another one. This one is the booster card for Death. I don't know if they actually matter, you know, which one they are, but all of these are scannable by anybody. Right, and there we have the death deck. But this one is the one that we have for order at the top, the very shiny, shiny look. First one we have is Liberator Prime. Here we have a Knight Heralder. This one says, Heroic Act, rotate highlighted Stormcast, unit 1 step forward. Here we have a Wizard. When this champion or a card controlled by champions grants you 4 or more health, you may rotate a highlighted unit 1 step backwards. This one is the Vandas Hammerhead. When a unit controlled by this champion is removed by your opponent, deal 3 damage to them. If you're going to be judgmental, be swift about it. So 4 damage to your opponent, increase this by 5 if the highlighted champion is disengaged. Here we got Divine Blast. It's 6 damage to your opponent and gain 2 health. Not a bad blessing. Healing Storm. We've got Storm Forge. This says when a highlighted Stormcast unit leaves, play, draw 1 card. Disruptive Liberator. Here we've got another one. Here is a Long Strike Raptor. He says, damage to your opponent increases by 2 if the highlighted champion is disengaged. Got another one. This one, I cannot say the word right, but he's a Paladin. That much damage to your opponent. Got a Paladin Protector. He says, reduce damage received from highlighted enemies by that much. Highlighted allies, units cannot be removed. We've got a Hurricane Raptor. Here we've got Star Drake. As this enters play, discard 1 card from your hand. Damage to your opponent, remove a highlighted unit. Strike Force Liberator. He says damage to your opponent increases by 2 if they have 20 or more health. Here is a Piercing Shot. 3 rend damage to your opponent. Here we have Warding Light. It is a spell. Damage to your opponent and gain that much health. Stand Fast. Best way to go. Highlighted units cannot rotate. Got a bit of Righteousness. Damage to your opponent. Reduce damage received from highlighted enemies by 2. Gift of Sigmar. This one can only be played by wizards. Gain 1 health. Increase this by 2 for each highlighted Stormcast unit. Got another Tactical Formation. That one helps you just kind of change your cards around if you didn't quite put them into place as you wanted. Got Triumph Smash. Remove a highlighted enemy spell or unit. If a card was removed, rotate a highlighted allied unit 1 step backwards. Restoring the Forge. Can only be played by a Stormcast champion. Shuffle up to 4 Stormcast units from your discard pile into your deck. Got Mystic Shield. Remember, when opportunity knocks, gotta strike it. Give us another one. Of course, our Arcane Bolts. Alright, we are on to the last one to open the orcs. Got the orc boss. He costs 1 and he gives you 1 life. Got another one. The Bone Splitter Shaman. The art is really cool as well. When a highlighted orc unit has support, 2, increase the champion damage done with spells by 3. Mega Boss on Maw Crusher. Nice. When this champion removes 1 or more highlighted units, gain 1 additional action this turn. This is the Renewed Warlust. Gain 4 health and draw 2 cards. That many damage to your opponent. 3, 3, and 3. Wow, I like that. Here is the Smash and Bash. I'm loving these names. They are great. 5 damage to your opponent. Rotate highlighted units to their final corner. Ushering of the Wah. Here we have Brute Smashes. We've got Auric Shield Bashers. Damage to your opponent, reduce damage received from highlighted enemies by increase this unit's damage reduction by 1 per support. Auric Scrapers. Grot Slashes. Damage to your opponent increases by 1 per support. We've got Pouncing Wolf Rider. Damage to your opponent, gain additional actions this turn. We've got a Crowded Wolf Chariot. This one says, can only be deployed onto a stack of 2, rend damage to your opponent. We've got Gore Chopper Brute. Damage to your opponent, if the highlighted champion costs 7 or more, the damage is done with rend. Here we've got Stomping Maw Crusher. Here we've got a Mob Rule. 2 damage to your opponent, increase the damage by 3 if this champion controls a unit with support 2. We've got an Invigorating Chant. We've got a Call of War. This is a spell. Deploy Auric or Grot units from your hand or deck onto a highlighted champion. A War Ceremony. This one says your highlighted units are dormant. Draw cards from each highlighted unit. Reckless Inspiration. Rotates a highlighted unit 2 steps forward. If this causes the unit to exhaust, gain 2 health and draw 2 cards. Got a Deadly Chop. I wouldn't want a lively one. Remove a highlighted spell or unit. 1 damage to your opponent. We've got a Rallying Cry. It's doing it quite well. Deploy 2 units from your hand onto any highlighted champion. We've got another Mystic Shield. Remember, when opportunity knocks, we strike it. Here is the scannable one. Right, now we can start into getting into opening the booster packs. Alright, so here we've got a Brute Smashers, we've got a Ravenous Crypt Ghoul, Soul Stealer, we've got a Piercing Shot, we've got an Invigorating Chant, we've got a Meat Shield Grot, some Enraged Olopix. This one says, damage to your opponent increases by 1 if a highlighted enemy has damaged you since your last turn. Here we've got a Sanction. This is a spell, Restoring the Forge. Frenzied Devotion. We've got the Lokian Prince. He says ignore any rend from highlighted champion units. Alright, my camera got tired and we're back again. So here's some Outrageous Carnage. And our last card of the deck looks just outright amazing. Crucling. Heroic Act, trigger the current effect of a highlighted spell as if it was controlled by this champion. Right, when opportunity knocks, we strike. We've got the Gaze of Mork. We've got a Feasting Vargeist. We've got a Call of the Grave. We've got some Righteousness. 2 Jaws of Death. We've got a Crypt Shield Skeletons. Here is the Surprising Scholars. We've got a Knight Heraldo. Wah, then wah again. I mean, if you're gonna do it, why not do it again? And the last one I am now really loving. I am looking at these as I show you, so I kinda don't see them before, so I saw this one now, and it is great. Alright, so we've got a Blue Flame. We've got a Mob Rule. We've got a really nice Blood Hunt. We've got a Paladin. Storm Shield. This is a spell. We've got a Soul Feeder. We've got a Skeletal Icon Bear. Brutal Smash. We've got an Infernal Gateway. Lord Variant. It's a champion. Now he costs 5, but he gives you -2 to your health.
off of pack. Got a griff. Got some demonic fury. Got a hellfire blast. It's a lightning strike. Got a fanatical skull fiend. Scrying pool. Got corns chosen. We've got a berserker. Reckless inspiration. Got another mega boss. It's called Hell Knight. It says heroic act, rotate a highlighted risen unit one step forward. Abjuration. Prowling wolf. Got a scorn of sorcery. Got our scrapers. Gift of Old Sigmar. Strike Force Liberator. Here is a spell. Battle Glory. Here we've got Reckless Juggernaut. Got a War Chant. Frenzy Blood Reaver. Here's the big Stava crew. Got another Call of War. We've got a Wizard, a Gaunt Summoner. We did not have this one before. Here we've got Unholy Power. So here we've got Favor of the Gods. Right, here we've got Triumphant Smash. We've got a Scorn of Sorcery. We've got a Lightning Strike. We've got a Cursed Strike. The Gaze of Mork, and what a gaze. Putrid Puke, oh, lovely. We've got a Skeletal Legion. A Surge of Justice. We've got the Celestial Prosecutor. The Prime Protector. There's a Blessing, the Might of Gork. Here we've got a Frenzied Charge, and then we've got another booster card. Here we've got another Paladin Protector. We've got another Zombie Dragon. We've got a Warding Light. And here we have an Alkaline Barrier Guard. I could be saying that wrong, but it does look quite cool. Commanding the Dead. We've got Brute Smashes. Got another War Chant. Got another Frenzy. Got that old Stabber Crew. Unmarked Deathbringer. Barrow's White King. So this is the Pennant of Sigmaron. Alright, so we have a Blood Reaver, the Feast of Mork. Here we have a Gore Slick Skull Reaper. Got round to another Blood Feast. Got a Storm Shield. Got some more Twisting Screamers. We've got some Brutish Resilience. Got another Enrage. We've got a Call of War, Frenzied War Chanter. Got the Storm's Descent. Got an Outrageous Carnage. Alright, we've got a Devour. A little more Puke. Got some Righteousness. Sweeping Namari Thrail, or Thrall, my bad. Got a Searing Firestorm. We've got an Ethereal Horde. Now that we've Wah and Wah again, we'll have a Wah Ceremony. Skeleton Warriors. We've got a Fate Weaver. He's really nice looking. We've got another Mega Dot Boss, but this one is the Riptooth Mega Boss. Got a Carrion Feast. Now we've got a Grave Call. On to our next pack, we have Commanding the Dead. Really, really nice spider here. I've got the infusion of Wah, so that we may do it again and again. Return of the Fallen. I've got a charging Blood Crusher. I've got another Zombie Dragon. Skeletal Legion. I've got another thing of bats. That Surge of Justice. Celestial Prosecutor. Protector Prime. We've got the Barrow's White King. Here we've got a Cursed Strike. We've got that Gaze of Morph. Got a Fanatical Skull Fiend. Gift of Sigmar. Alright, here we have Chaotic Restoration. Here we have Unholy Vitality. We've got another Ethereal Horde. Here we have a Swift Namarti Reaver. Blood for the Blood God. We've got the Wah Chanter. Here we've got a Trampling Grunter. Here we've got a Wizard. A Grot Shaman Spider Rider. What a name for that one. Here we've got Zanich Fortune. Crowded Wolf Chariot. Ravenous Crypt Ghoul. And when opportunity knocks, we strike. Got a Feast. Got a Pouncing Wolf Rider. Here we've got a Stormstrike Fulminator. Here we've got a Murderous Vargeist. We've got another Brutal Smash. We've got Empower the Hordes. Here we have a Rune Marked Deathbringer. So here we have the Exalted Deathbringer. And we got a foil of one of the Might of Gork. I probably do like the foil version better. Got another Arcane Bolt. Got a Piercing Shot. Got some Unholy Vitality. Got an Alpha Griff Charger. Got a Disruptive Liberator. Got some Wah Infusion so that we can Wah and Wah again. Got the Wah Call so we know how to Wah. Some Reckless Inspiration, my favorite kind. Got a Capricious Flamer. Induced Fury. And we've got a massive Chopper War Boss. We've got some Morbid Terror. If you guys are interested in seeing maybe some playthrough games, some practice games, do let me know because I would love to be able to set that up and kind of put some out there for you guys. I have a few other decks that I would like to try out. Achillean Bearer Guard. We've got a Grot Sloshes. We've got a Grave Call. We've got a Furious Strike. It's a Scorn of Sorcery. We've got a Hellfire Blast. This one is really nice. We've got a Searing Light. A Divine Vengeance. Got a good old Soul Feast. Here we've got an Arthurling Scout. I do believe we haven't seen him before. We've got a Frenzied War Chanter. We've got a Lord Relictor. And for our last foil, we have a Demonic Fury. I really, really like that red.
Hello all you beautiful space travelers, it is Spacebird and this is the end of the video, not the beginning. I didn't quite do an intro just because I thought it would be better just to start off with the box. That was super, super fun to open. I got a lot of good stuff, kind of have a lot of new ideas for different, you know, decks that I want to play, different things that I want to try, and like I said, if you're interested in actually seeing some playthroughs or playtests or even, you know, just talking about a deck that I've worked on or made or whatever, I was super lucky to be able to get this because there was only 1,000 and there was like 5 minutes left to be able to buy it, so I luckily was able to snag one. I hope you enjoyed the unboxing and hopefully I can make, you know, a few more videos on this because The rules are really simple, and even though they're really simple, there's a lot you can kind of do with the game.